other Mida team is taking the ice. Emily and Ian have found a lot of success very quickly on in their career. A top five finish last year in their inaugural season together as a team. They were sixth at both of their Grand Prix. This is a team to watch out headed into the 2026 Olympics. This is Emily Bratti and Ian Somerville.
Actually, I've been blown away with the quality of skating from this team, and this performance is magical.
Was just so beautiful. This team is so endlessly talented. I am constantly in awe of them and the work that they put in. This is a team that loves skating. They love what they do. They love...
the training process, and you've really been able to watch them just improve over the season. This is something they're going to be really, really happy with.
Ash, I just want to reiterate to everybody watching at home how fast and how much ice coverage
and control, too. They're fast, but they get that depth of edge that we're looking for, and that is really, really hard to do when you start to incorporate speed and power. And that's something that has really impressed me with this team.
Something that frightens me.
Okay, I love fear. Let's hear it.
Something that frightens me is that this is how they're skating now.
And they're new.
How good will it be? How good can it get? I think the ceiling is just, the sky's the limit with this team.
The ceiling doesn't exist. It wasn't built. They don't even have to worry about it. I mean, we were talking with Coach Charlie White, and he was just singing them praise, saying how crazy talented he feels like they are. Their twizzle sequence in the rhythm dance is one of the hardest in the world, and they're also a team that's really confident in their ability. When we were talking to them right before this Nationals, and we asked them, what makes you special? I will never forget that she did this. She starts counting off of her fingers.
She gave us a list.
She gave
of all
us
the things
a bulleted list. Some highlight points, but she's not wrong. But they don't have to go out and try hard to make you understand why they're special. They are just effortlessly very special to watch. My one complaint with this. No Makita Pa, it's so emotional. It's so raw. And their skating, I can see where they've really put the work in to carry that through. But it just, you lose me in a couple moments with the emotion. But the movement, the skating, it's really just something else. It's stunning.
I feel like as they mature, the emotion will come across so much. But Ash, I felt it.
Oh,
and it
God.
Was through the speed. It was through the power. These lifts, it's just, they are both such incredible skaters. I'm blown away.
Also, you all couldn't see it, but there are four people in this arena doing this program. And one of them was Greg Zuerlein, and the other was Tanith White. They were all doing the choreography together as one. It was a quartet.
And we love a good quartet.
Yes, when half of the quartet is on the ice, you know it's a good program. Also, we did just get confirmation. Chalk and Bates told Andrea Joyce that they are planning on competing. We love a little drama.
Oh, we love a little drama. And ice dance, you need it.
And the flu is dramatic.
Believe me, it is dramatic.
And traumatic. 118.8.
Wow.
That is a mammoth score for this team. 196.9.
So well deserved.
Oh, my God. A new season's best. That is a great score for this team, something they should be so proud of. They expressed frustration that they weren't even named as alternates to the Four Continents team, and I think they did a great job here at showing exactly why they are a team to watch in seasons.